Chairman Graham, Ranking Member Feinstein, and members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify in connection with the Supreme Court nomination of Judge Amy Coney Barrett. My name is Kristen Clarke, President and Executive Director of the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights Under Law, one of the nation's oldest civil rights organizations. Founded in 1963 at the request of President John F. Kennedy, we turn to the courts to protect the civil rights and voting rights of Black people and other communities of color across our nation. We've conducted an exhaustive review of Judge Barrett's writings, speeches, and decisions during her time on the court. Judge Barrett's views are far outside the mainstream, and for evidence of this, one need look no further than her own words before this committee this week. Judge Barrett would not say whether voter intimidation is illegal, though outlawed by Section 11B of the Voting Rights Act and federal criminal laws. Judge Barrett would not concede that voting discrimination still exists, saying she could not endorse that proposition and calling it a very charged issue when questioned about the court's Shelby County versus Holder decision. Even Chief Justice Roberts, the author of that devastating ruling, noted, quote, "Voting discrimination still exists? No one doubts that." Judge Barrett would not say whether absentee ballots are essential to voting in the pandemic, calling it a matter of policy on which she can't express a view. Judge Barrett has left open the possibility that she would participate in cases that may arise out of the election now underway. It's troubling that she would not recuse herself under these circumstances, and her stance sends a disconcerting message to the 17 million Americans who have voted to date, with millions more to come. These are voters who want their ballots and not an election season court pick to determine the election outcome. Her record reflects the same. In Cantor versus Barr, she suggested the right to vote deserves less protection than the right to own a gun. And that's a radical point of view, no matter what one's view of the Second Amendment. In her words, she described the right to serve on juries and to vote as belonging only to, quote, virtuous citizens. She's made clear that her judicial philosophy has been molded by the late Justice Scalia, who described the Voting Rights Act as, quote, a perpetuation of a racial entitlement. When asked if she agreed with this, she refused to answer. During these hearings, Judge Barrett has gone to great lengths to distance herself from the reality of voter suppression and voting discrimination that we face today. This should sound an alarm to anyone in our country who cares about protecting voting rights for all Americans. In this moment, we're in lower courts fighting efforts to purge voters from the rolls, efforts to shutter polling sites in communities of color, burdensome restrictions such as notary and witness requirements for those casting absentee ballots during the pandemic, and more. And this term, the court will decide a case arising out of Arizona, where the issue concerns racial discrimination in voting under both the Constitution and Section 2 of the Voting Rights Act. Given Judge Barrett's unwillingness to recognize the threats that Black people and communities of color face in voting, I'm deeply concerned about how she would handle this case and many other such cases that will come before the court. A brief word on employment discrimination. Judge Barrett revealed alarming insensitivity to racial harassment in the workplace in Smith versus Illinois Department of Transportation. There she held that a Black traffic patrol driver was not subject to a hostile work environment, even though coworkers frequently subjected him to use of the N-word. Judge Barrett concluded that this was an egregious racial epithet, but concluded that this sort of racial hostility was not enough to prove discrimination. This stance is simply incomprehensible. The nomination of Justice Barrett arises at one of the most tumultuous times in our nation's history. We're wrestling with a pandemic, protests about unconstitutional policing practices, racial injustice, and more. Our nation deserves a justice who is committed to protecting the hard-earned rights of all Americans, particularly our nation's most vulnerable. For these reasons, the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights Under Law opposes Judge Barrett's nomination. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Clarke.